Hello and welcome to Ruchi's Town. Today we are outdoors. It's a weekend and we are cooking biryani on the fire here outside. So come, let's get into the video and see how we are going to do it.
I kept all the items required for the biryani and the vessels that were required for cooking. So I just got it three times. I kept it in all trays from the kitchen to the table. In three different lots I got it, and I didn't want to keep on going between the house and the place that I was cooking. So you can pause the video here and keep a note if you're doing it yourself outside sometime, so that you don't miss out on anything that you would require. And I also kept a lot of masalas together, and potatoes, garam masalas, ginger garlic paste and all I had made. So they are all kept ready. It was not just about cooking, we wanted to have it as a relaxed evening also, doing everything together. So we were having some fun as well. We were talking, we were playing. It was good evening actually. After a busy gardening in the morning, it was a very good evening. So the sticks are all burning well. So I have cooked in a setup like this in the past in India as a regular thing. I have done it. And here it is, it's again I'm doing here. So I put the garam masala and whole garam masala and green chilies into the oil there. When we are making in the gas stove, we don't have to check if the fire is proper and all. Here we have to keep checking that regularly. So if you're doing this, use a wooden spoon, that would help out. I've added onions also there, and I'm frying, and I've added some salt so that it fries well. It doesn't take much time. It took barely 3 minutes for the onions to get fried completely. I didn't keep any chopping work here. I had made everything ready in the kitchen itself. And you have to keep stirring it because of the heat. It'll get burnt very quickly. So if you see, they're all chilling out. I had made some lemonade, so it was so hot outside, and it was the heat of the stove also. The lemonade got over in like a jiffy. If you see, I had both the wooden spatula as well as the steel one. I used the I had to keep the steel one down because it was really getting very hot. When the biryani was done, it had a smoky effect. And one more thing is, when we are cooking in this, we have to keep closing the lid often, which I did not do initially. I just did it like we do it in the kitchen. But here, it is important that we close it regularly. So if you are doing this, follow that. We should not forget and touch the vessel. It was so hot, extremely hot. The stand on the stove that I have kept here is the one which we would have on the stove top in the kitchen on the gas. That one I had got and kept it here so that it is convenient to keep the vessel. Onions are fried. Now I'm going to add the chicken. So we have to put some water or any liquid kind of a thing after we put the chicken. If not, it is going to get caught to the vessel. That's what I observed. And even the heat is very high actually. Now I'm going to add all the dry masala, which will be chili powder, coriander powder, pepper powder, turmeric powder and some garam masala powder. All this together I kept in a small bowl. I'm adding that at a time. I kept all the masalas limited. I did not make it too spicy. When I've cooked in such a stove in India, when there was no gas or anything like that. We ran out of gas that time when I used to cook in such stoves. But my mom was always there, or my dad would be there, so I knew like where to stop, what to do. This is like completely doing all by ourselves was learning. The stones were too far apart, so we felt that the vessel was moving, so we fixed it later. Now I'm adding the ginger garlic paste, and also had pasted some whole garam masala also. All together I have put in there. That is bay leaf, elaichi and all. This is the frozen mint and coriander leaves. If you have the fresh leaves, go ahead and put that later. That also had some water, so it should help the chicken not stick to the... Ha ha! There it is! The stove gave up! So he was basically wearing a fireproof gloves. Those tongs or those handle that I had put, right, that also had become very hot. I had to remove that. Even the kitchen gloves or the baking gloves that I had was of no use here. Due to the heat, even that was melting off. I added some yogurt. And I've also added some potatoes that were there. If you see my videos regularly, I usually add potatoes for my chicken or mutton biryani. I applied some mud on the vessel before I started cooking so that it is easy for me to clean later. Finally, I closed the lid. So if you're making it, make sure you close the lid and open it regularly and keep stirring it, unlike you do it in the regular kitchen. When we planned this, we were not sure if it would how the weather would be. It was gloomy, and then finally the weather was right and we started doing this. We did some photo shoot. We played for some time. So those are the flowers from the garden. Look at it. Just right behind this, there is a small forest. There was deers that were there also. I added water to this. So in case you usually add 1:1 for basmati rice, say you have 5 cups of basmati rice, don't just add 5 cups of water, add 2 more extra cups, due to the heat, the water will get evaporated really fast, and this is not even a cooker that we are doing it in. So it's very important that you add more water than it is required. I added salt also. Before that, I added tomatoes also. Now I'm going to let the chicken cook, at least 3/4 cook, before I put the dum. As soon as we put all these things, we could smell that how it would be in a wedding or anything like that, or roadside when they are making it, how it would be. It smelled exactly like that. So the rice is soaking there. I'm having some cucumber that I had kept. Now we were talking that in case we are going on a camp, we know that even biryani can be cooked easily. If you have a right group of friends who actually enjoy all these things, it would be good than just like one or two people going out on a trek and doing stuff. People who share the same kind of interest and who are more enthusiastic and don't fuss around, such people we have to go with. It'll be so much fun. though this is regular in India, when we are doing this here, it is something really different. We do barbecue here, but doing this is like totally an experience. So the chicken is cooked. I'm adding the rice. I've soaked this basmati rice just before I came here, so it has been soaking for about 30 minutes now. In case you put a little extra water, you don't have to worry. When we put the dum, the biryani will be cooked perfectly and it will not be like water and all. So the important tip is more water. Next, I'm squeezing some lemon juice. This is quarter of a lemon that we had. This is a very big size lemon. I'm squeezing that. So if it's a small lemon or lime that you get in India, put one full. I've taken 3 cups of basmati rice. That's 450 grams of basmati rice basically. And some ghee. Finally, ghee. So once I add ghee, that means it's done. So we are going to put some dum right now. That means some coal we are going to take and put it on top of the lid. I put some lemon there because there is a small vent there in the lid. So I put a lemon so that the charcoal or coal doesn't dust doesn't go inside. Important thing here. When you are putting the dum, you have to make sure there is not too much fire below or underneath this. So if there is fire, it will get burnt at the bottom, which is what we did not note. That's how we actually do it while doing in the kitchen, right? I forgot about it totally, and we had fire there below, and finally when we took the biryani out, some of the biryani was stuck to the vessel. If I had avoided that and if we had removed this fire completely at this point in time, the biryani would not get stuck to the vessel. So while the dum, we had put dum for like 15 minutes, we were playing. We usually play. Every day in the evening, we play outside for at least an hour. So because of this, we had missed that out. We were playing for some time. And we took the biryani out. And we are going to keep this like this for at least another 10 minutes. And after 10 minutes, I am removing it. It's the moment of truth. We will know how it would come out. If you see, there's no water at the top, which is the most amazing thing. Let me mix it and see and show it to you. If you see, the rice is so grainy. It has become like noodles, like semia basically, vermicelli.
Wow.
Awesome biryani.
And it was cooked well also.
How did you make this here?
It had that smoky effect. We enjoyed it so much. When we ate it, then we told so many times that it is tasty and we were eating it.
Bring one more
plate to it. Welcome.
So it's not sticking to each other.
Take this plate and...
We served it with raita and some cucumber. And... yeah, it was totally worth it. We don't have barbecue table set up here basically. So we had this kids table and we used that up for having. I can't imagine I made biryani here in the US in a setup like this. This is like a totally unbelievable thing. We just spoke, okay, let's do it. And then, yeah, there you go. We did it. So if there is a big group of friends and we do all together, wow, it would be so good. Now all this situation is so different that we cannot think of that also right now. It was so hot, actually too hot when I ate it. We felt like eating it in India in some restaurant. Amazing it was. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Ruchi's Town.